Section 1.4. This video will help you simplify a fraction, multiply fractions and mixed numbers, and divide fractions and mixed numbers. Let's start with some definitions here under simplifying a fraction. Equivalent fractions are equal in value but are written differently. And a fraction is in simplest form when its numerator and denominator have no common factors other than one. Now let's take a look at some examples that will help you understand equivalent fractions and simplest form. So example one here, compare the pictures of 3/6 and 1/2 below. So here we have 3/6, you know, three shaded out of six boxes in total. And here we have the fraction 1/2. One box shaded out of two boxes total. And you can see based on these pictures, you know, that 3/6 and 1/2 are the same amount. So these are the same amount, so these are equivalent fractions. 1/2 is the simplest form of these fractions because that's the simplest way to describe this amount. So this amount in both cases is the same, and the easiest way to describe that is with 1/2. Now let's take a look at another equivalent fraction. So 3/6, 1/2, and also this 9/18. Those are all equivalent fractions. Those are all equal to 1/2. Let's take a look at how we're going to simplify this 9/18 to get that down to its simplest form, which is 1/2. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to factor both the 9 and the 18, and I'm going to do that using a factor tree. So I'm going to come over here and some scratch work here. So when I factor the 9, I'm thinking any two numbers that multiply together to give me 9, besides 9 and 1, that's not going to help us factor this. So I'm thinking, okay, well 3 times 3 will give me 9. So I'm going to factor 9 into 3 times 3. Now, 3 is a prime number. I cannot factor that anymore. So that's as much factoring as I can do. So I'm going to come over here on 9, and I'm going to replace 9 with this factoring, 3 times 3. Now I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing with 18 here. There's 18. I'm thinking any two numbers that multiply to give me 18, so let's say 3 times 6, that gives me 18. 3 is prime, but I'm going to go ahead and factor 6 again because 6 is a composite number, meaning I can still factor this out. So 6, that factors into 2 times 3. Now if I take the ends of these tree branches here, just the ends of the tree branch, which is right here, like that. If I take just the ends of those tree branches, that will give me now the prime factorization of 18. And a lot of times you hear people say that's just 18 in its factored form. So let's see here. So 18 factored into 3 times 2 times 3. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to look for common factors in the numerator and denominator and divide those common factors out. So it looks like we're sharing a common factor of 3 here, so I'm going to divide a 3 out of the top, which would leave me with 1, 3 out of the bottom, which also leaves me with 1. There's also another common factor of 3 here, so I'll divide that one out, divide that one out. Now what I'm going to do to get my final simplified answer is just multiply the factors that are left. And in the top I have 1 times 1. Well, 1 times 1 is just 1. And in the denominator, I have 1 times 2, which is just 2. So you can see, when I simplify 9/18, I get this equivalent fraction, 1/2. Now it's time to check your understanding of equivalent fractions and simplifying a fraction. Go ahead and pause your video player and answer these practice questions. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. All right, question 3. Compare the pictures for 6/18, which is right here, and 1/3 below. Well, 6/18 and 1/3, we can say, since those things are equal in value, but are written differently, those are equivalent fractions. All right, of those equivalent fractions, 1/3 is in its simplest form. Now let's go ahead and take a look at how we're going to simplify this, get 6/18 down to its simplest form of 1/3. So draw a big fraction bar here, come off to the side with some scratch work. I'm going to factor 6, and I'm going to factor 18. All right, 6, that's just going to be 2 times 3. 18, we just factored this one. I was thinking 3 times 6 last time I did that, so I'll factor it the same way. 3 is prime, 6 is not, so we break that down again one more time. We'll take the ends of the tree branches there. And so there's my factoring for 18. 3 times 2 times 3. Now we're looking to divide out common factors. So we have a common factor of 2. When I divide it out here, there'll be a 1. Divide it out there, there'll be a 1. And a common factor of 3 in both the numerator and denominator. So it looks like in the numerator, I'm going to have 1 times 1, or 1. In the denominator, just 3. And so I've simplified now 6/18 down to 1/3. All right, now let's take a look at some examples that'll help you understand how to multiply fractions and mixed numbers. So the nice thing about that factoring thing is it really can make it easier now when we go to multiply. Because what we do when we multiply is we basically go straight across, multiply the numerators and denominators. But it's always going to make it easier, or most of the time it's going to make it easier, if we factor these things out and simplify them before we multiply. So here's what that looks like. I'm going to draw just one big fraction bar, just like I did when I was simplifying. And now I'm going to go across the top and just factor these things. Well, 2 is prime, so I'm just going to write that as 2. 9, when I factor that out, that's 3 times 3. All right, now going across the denominators. 3, well, 3 is prime. 10, I'm thinking 2 times 5 when I factor 10. Once I get this factored now, I can look to divide out any common factors. And so notice we have a common factor of 2 and a common factor of 3. And so we're going to get right to our final simplified answer here. In the numerator, I have 1 times 1 times 3, which is 3. And in the denominator, 1 times 1 times 5, which is 5. And so we go straight to our simplified form here because we simplified as we were multiplying this thing out. Okay, now let's take a look at this mixed number here. I got a mixed number in this problem, and we don't ever multiply with a mixed number. So I want to change this mixed number into an improper fraction. So this is how I do that. I kind of work in a circle. First, we're going to multiply the 4 times the 2. We're going to take that answer and then add it to the top of the fraction. So the way I work through this, I'd say, okay, 4 times 2 is 8. 8 plus 1 is 9. So I'm writing 9 as the numerator of that fraction. The denominator of 2 is not going to change. So that's just going to become the improper fraction, 9 halves. And now I'm taking 9 halves times 1/3. Once I get to this point, now this multiplication is done the same way we did the multiplication above. So I'm going to go through and factor this thing out, going across the top here. I have 9, which factors into 3 times 3, and then times 1. Going across the denominators, I have 2 times 3. Now I'm going to look to divide out a common factor, and these do share a common factor of 3, so I'm going to divide that out. Looks like in the numerator, then I have 3 times 1, or 3. And in the denominator, I have 2 times 1, which is 2. Now, I am ending up here with an improper fraction, meaning this numerator is bigger than the denominator, so this fraction is actually larger than 1, and that's what makes a fraction improper. So, some instructors will want you to leave it like this, 3 halves, which is fine. They also might want you to write this as a mixed number. And so let's come over here and look at this thing as a mixed number. So this is a division problem. 2 is going into 3. So let me write that out as a long division problem. 2 going into 3. 2 goes into 3 one whole time. And when I subtract it away, I'll get a remainder of 1. Now, I can take this information and write this as a mixed number. So here's what that looks like as a mixed number. 2 went into 3 one whole time with a remainder of 1. And then we write that remainder over the original denominator. So denominator was 2. Or over here, denominator was 2. In the mixed number, it's also going to remain 2. So you could have either of these answers, depending on what your instructor is going to want. Now it's time to check your understanding of multiplying fractions and mixed numbers. Go ahead and pause your video player and answer these questions. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. All right, question 7. We're going to start by factoring this thing out. The 4, that factors into 2 times 2. 3 is prime, so we'll leave it just like that. 6, that factors into 2 times 3. 10, that factors into 2 times 5. Looking at our common factors here, common factor of 2 is going to divide out. Another common factor of 2 is going to divide out. And a common factor of 3 is going to divide out. Almost everything divided out here. So going across the numerators, notice everything is divided out, so all we're left with that is 1 times 1 times 1, which is just 1. And in the denominator, we're going to have 1 times 1 times 1 times 5, or just 5 left in the denominator. So our final simplified answer there is 1/5. Question 8, we want to turn both of these things into improper fractions. So working in a circle, I'm going to say 2 times 5 is 10. 10 plus 2 is 12. So I get 12 over the original denominator of 5. Here I'll say, okay, 3 times 4 is 12. 12 plus 1 is 13. So that's going to be 13 over 4. Now, let's factor this thing out and see if we have any common factors. 12, I'm thinking 3 times 4. Well, here's 3. And then 4, I could factor that again. So when I write 4, I'm going to write that as 2 times 2. So there's 3 times 4, but I broke the 4 down because it wasn't factored out all the way. Times 13, that's a prime number, so I can't factor that at all. The 5, that's a prime number. I can't factor that at all. And the 4 here, that's going to be 2 times 2. Okay, looking at my problem now, I have a pair of common factors here, 2 2's, so I'm going to divide each of those out. One on the top, one on the bottom. So it looks like I'm left with 3 times 13 in the numerator, which is 39, and then just 5 in the denominator. So this answer might be okay, or if we divide this out, 5 goes into 39 7 whole times. Well, 7 times 5 is 35, so that leaves a remainder of 4, so I'm going to write that remainder over the original denominator. So either of those answers, depending on what your structure wants, are correct. Divide by fractions and mixed numbers. Let's take a look at a definition. Two numbers are reciprocals if their product is 1. And remember, product means multiply. So if we take two numbers who are reciprocals and we multiply them together, we're going to get 1. That's good because that's going to help us when we start solving equations, the fact that reciprocals, when we multiply them together, they give us 1. There's an easier way to find the reciprocal of a fraction, and that is simply to flip the fraction. So let's take a look at some examples here that will help us understand how to find a reciprocal and also how to divide with fractions. Let's take a look at some examples now that will help you understand how to find a reciprocal and how to divide by a fraction or mixed number. Example 9. So we're asked to find the reciprocal of 3/4. So really the easy way to do that is just flip it. So the reciprocal of 3/4 is just going to be 4/3. And just as a note here, you wouldn't have to write this down, but remember reciprocals, when we multiply them together, give us 1, so I want to show you that real quick. 3/4 times 4/3. Well, remember we can divide when we're multiplying, we can divide common factors out here, and so notice we can divide a common factor of 3 out and a common factor of 4 out, and you can see why a reciprocal, a fraction times a reciprocal is just going to give us 1 as an answer, because all the common factors are going to divide right out. Okay, let's take a look at question 10 now, and you'll see why we need a reciprocal. All right, this is a division problem, and most of the time when we run into division problems with fractions, they don't work out very nice. If we looked at the denominator here, we could do the denominator okay. 5 divided by 5, that would give us 1, that's pretty nice. But if we look at the numerator here, 4 divided by 9, that's going to work out ugly, and we're going to end up with a fraction inside of a fraction. So what we do is we take division problems, and we turn them into multiplication. And here's how we do that. We leave the first fraction as it is. We take the reciprocal of the second fraction. It was 9/5, so I'm going to flip that around to 5/9. And then we multiply. These two problems, 4/5 divided by 9/5, and 4/5 times 5/9, they have exactly the same answer. And this multiplication problem is easier to do. Once we have it as a multiplication problem, we're going to follow the exact same steps that we did before. So I'm going to write a big fraction bar here, factor out the common factors, and multiply what's left. So 4, I'm thinking 2 times 2. 5 is prime. Down in the denominator, 5. And then 9 is 3 times 3. So it looks like we have a common factor of 5 that we'll divide out there. And we'll get our final answer then of 4/9. Okay, example 11. We're dividing now, and we have a mixed number involved. Just like with multiplication, we can't divide with a mixed number. So the first thing we're going to have to do is turn this mixed number into an improper fraction. So I work in a circle. I'm going to say 5 times 1 is 5, plus 1 is 6, so that's going to be 6/5, divided by, and this is already okay, 9/6. Now, you might be tempted right here to divide out that common factor of 6, but we cannot do that. You cannot divide common factors out when it's a division problem. That only works when it's multiplication. So we want to first now turn this into multiplication. So first fraction stays the same, 6/5. We take the reciprocal of the second fraction, which is 6/9, and then we turn the division into multiplication. Now, once we got it as multiplication, we can factor this thing out. So let's come over here and we'll finish this. Big fraction bar going across the top. 6 is 2 times 3, and that next 6 is 2 times 3. Going across the denominators now. 5 is prime. 9 is 3 times 3. Looks like we got some common factors here. Common factors of 3, a pair of 3s. And so that's going to leave us with 4/5 for our final answer. One little saying note over here. Let's take a look at this. So one thing that will help you turn a division problem into a multiplication problem is there's a little saying here that kind of has a rhyme to it, which will help you. And that is called skip, flip, multiply. That's how we turn division into multiplication. Skip meaning the first fraction stays the same. Flip meaning we take the reciprocal of the second fraction and then multiply. So you can think of it like this. Skip, flip, multiply, if that helps. Now it's time to check your understanding of dividing fractions and mixed numbers. Go ahead and pause your video player and answer these practice questions. When you're done, hit play to see how you did. Okay. Question 12, we're asked to find the reciprocal of 2/9. So all we got to do is flip that. That's just going to be 9/2. Question 13, first we'll change this to multiplication. Skip, flip, multiply. Skip the first one, flip the second one, and then turn it to multiplication. Once we're there, we can factor this thing out across the numerator. 2 times 3 times 3, across the denominator. 3 times 2 times 2, common factors of 2, common factors of 3. So let's come around here. So it looks like our final simplified answer is going to be 3/2, which is a good answer. Or your instructor might want you to write that as a mixed number. And so we would say 2 goes into 3 one whole time with a remainder of 1. And so we write that over the original denominator. So depending on your instructor's preference, either of those answers will be correct. Question 14. We're asked to divide now, and we got a mixed number in there, so let's first turn that to improper. So 3 times 2 is 6, 6 plus 2 is 8, so that's 8/3. Now I want to flip the second one, so that's 6/7, and then turn the division to multiplication, factor it. 8, when I break 8 down, I'm thinking 4 times 2, but then I got to break that 4 down again. So we actually get 3 2's when we factor an 8 out. 1, 2, 3. Now I'm going to factor the 6. That's 2 times 3. Going across the denominator, 3 is prime, 7 is prime, so we don't need to factor that. Let's see. Looks like just a pair of 3's here in common, so we'll divide that out. Going across the top now, we'll get 2 times 2 is 4. Times 2 again is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. In the denominator, 7. So 16/7, or if we divide that out and write it as a mixed number, 7 goes into 16 two whole times with a remainder of 2. So 2 and 2/7, or 16/7.